reaction to Sword Art Online Alicization Season 3, Episode 5, guys. Let's jump right into this. And I'm sorry, guys. Oh, look! Season 1? I wonder why they're showing this. Laughing cough in that battle that we had with them. Oh, why, we're back to the present? Wow. We're gonna see what's going on here. This is what we needed? Because I had so many questions, like, what's really going on? You know, where's Kirito? Imagine how Asuna feels. She feels terrible. Because it's like, you know, he protected her. But you know, honestly, like, I mean, of course, she shouldn't feel guilty or anything. Like, he protected her. That's the right thing to do. Also, guys, I'll wait for the opening to come before I speak. I need to pay attention to this fully. Is he in a coma? It has to be a coma. Yep, coma. He may never regain consciousness. Like, yep. Oh, man. Man, that has to be like the worst. Think about it, right? You know, at least about like comas and stuff, like that's kind of scary. Not even kind of, like really scary. Because think about it, right? You're sleeping for all this time and it's like you're alive, but you're really not. And it's like it takes years. Sometimes some people can wake up from coma like from like 5 years, 2 years kind of thing. And they wake up and it's like time has passed so much people kept living. Whoo, that's something scary. And you know what I wanted to say is, I'm sorry for like me not getting these reactions out on time. I promise this week I'll try to get better with it. But the thing is, on Saturdays I work really late. So because I work really late on Saturdays, it's hard for me to, you know, react to this. I mean, I can, but it's like, and what I mean by react, it's going to be hard for me to react on time without like interruptions. Because of the time I come from work, there's so many interruptions and whatnot. Then I have to wake up early for next time, so I can't even react late at night. Because the next day I have to wake up for work. Yeah, but that's just why, like, Goblin Slayer or Sword Art Online is never really up on Saturdays. So I just, you know, I'm going to try to do it this Saturday. Like, not, you know, let it overstack like that. I'm going to try to get it. Beautiful opening. Ocean Turtle. So are we going to be getting it from Asuna's perspective this episode? Why do you need to check with that? What? That's stupid! But then again, I guess for his sake, right? But still! Yeah, something, yeah, it's fishy. Yeah, this is fishy. They probably know, like, what's going on with Kirito right now, like, you know. Yep. That's the, you know, new weapon machine they have. I was gonna say weapon. He was testing out something, right? Oh yeah, the heart rate, right? Oh yeah? Oh, Yui! I forgot about Yui for a little bit. Okay. Is there another? Yeah, there is, right? Fishy? Klein! Wait, is the whole gang in the car? Look at this, everyone's working together to figure this out. Just, you know, you need friends like this? You need friends like this, guys, honestly? It's in one of these, like, warehouses, is it? But we can't enter here. That's, like, breaking and, you know what I mean, trespassing. So it's us. I was wondering what that was. So it's like the way they can connect with Yui, like communicate with her. Look at this, they took him to a whole different place. What was this episode called again? Something about water, was it? Exactly. That is true. Don't lose hope. Yeah, don't give up. I like this episode because you see, we mostly got episodes from Kirito's perspective, but now we're getting to see everyone else's, like how they're really acting and how they feel with the whole situation with Kirito. Kojiro Ringo. Look at that. So they had relations. Look. It has to be from Asumi. Yep. Ocean Turtle. That's what it was called. Ocean Turtle. Yep, so this is where Kirito is. He's transported here, I'm assuming. Ocean Turtle. This place, this facility. Okay, she came up like, nice to meet you. So she's just speaking English? I love it. How come we can't see her face? Yo, I feel like, because we couldn't see her face with the sunglasses off. Maybe it's not a big deal, right? Look, that's the world. He's like in his bathrobe or something. No, it's not a bathrobe, it's some, you know. Higa? Asuna! I knew it! I was gonna say it, guys, but I didn't want to look like an idiot. I know, closed mouths don't get fed, but I swear, guys, I knew it because the message, and now she's with this strange, anonymous person, and it's like this person's in, you know? We don't see the face. Why? It's Asuna! look at that. So she helped her. Look at that! That's how they did it? Yeah! With Kirito! Nice! Nice! Guys, I swear to you, I was gonna say something about it being Asuna, but you see the whole thing with me, then I started thinking in my head, I was like, could it possibly be Asuna? I was like, wait, the hair is different, of course, but now we see it's a wig. I mean, of course, the whole, and we didn't see the eyes, so I was like, they're not showing us her eyes, because, you know, if we saw the eyes, we would have dead on knew it was Asuna. And so I was like, why did it keep showing her with the glasses? How come, you know, of course, it's supposed to signify something, but, you know, I had a feeling, I should have said it when I had it. From now on, I'm going to start saying it, but, you know, it's just that sometimes I have this whole dilemma where I'm like, what if I say it? And they're like, you're an idiot. How could that be Asuna? She speaks English. And you know, of course, the hairstyle and all that, you guys would have probably said something like that. That's what I was scared of. But I should have just said it. This episode, like I said, I really enjoyed this episode. Because you see, we're seeing everything from like Kirito's perspective. But it's good because, you know, I was wondering too. I was like, yo, what? How's Asuna's doing? You know what I mean? How is she doing? What's happening with Kirito's body? Those type of questions were raised, you know what I mean? Because it's like, what's going on in his end of time now? You know what I mean? What's happening there instead of just showing us this whole journey and whatnot? Of course, we love seeing this happening with Kirito and everything, like, you know, with Yu-Gi-Oh and Kirito on the journey, getting Alice and all that. But still, what's going on the flip side? What's happening with Kirito's body? How is he, you know, is he, and we know he's obviously in a coma. I'm assuming next episode, it may still be about Asuna. Like, I don't think we're gonna get Kirito next episode, because I just seen the title, like an idiot spoiling myself. It just popped up. It's called Project Alicization. So I'm assuming that's gonna be, you know, explaining the project. Maybe we'll get Kirito. I don't know. I don't know what to expect. But this is a really good episode, because you see, the whole thing is, we know like they're trying to do something fishy with Kirito, but we don't really know, and we know it's dealing with the soul. So we learned this episode, like, you know, he's currently in, you know, a coma state, like, and who knows, because, like, he can recover, but then there's also a chance that he can never recover, which is really scary, you know, like, and Asuna, everyone who loves him, it's like, for them, they're like, wow, Kirito. You know, like, oh my gosh, can he make it? And, you know, they're losing hope. And I really love how Yui just snaps Asuna into her senses. She's like, have faith in him and don't give up. Because when, you know, like, exactly, Alfenheim, when that happened, Kirito never gave up. He kept saying, I'm going to find Asuna. He had Yui on his side. And, you know, I just love seeing how the roles have been reversed. Now, in this time, it's like, Kirito is lost. And, you know, he has to be found. And Asuna is going to be the one to find him. I mean, who knows, right? If she's gonna, I mean, most necessarily it's gonna be her. You know what I mean? But still, last time it was Kirito and he was trying to find her. So I really love that. Like, this is really great. And what else am I trying to talk about? Just seeing everyone, you know, putting the effort, working together, like, Klein, everyone, you know, and it's like, we're all just friends. Like, they're good friends. Honestly, I love that scene as well. I mean, you just see everyone working together to help find out about Raph and all that. Like, oh, what is really going on? Is Kirito transported here? Where is Kirito? Because we care about Kirito. We want to make sure that he's okay. We want to make sure they're not doing anything, you know, harmful to him and whatnot. But yeah, a very great episode. Of course, I'm definitely going to have to rewatch to catch things maybe that I missed about, like, the whole procedure and all that, you know, good stuff. But, you know, that happens with all animes. Thank you for watching. If you made it to the end, you're amazing. Yo, peace out.